Hi all, it's V. And this is day 4 of our North Coast 500 trip. And it was my birthday, so I celebrated with an iced coffee right by Loch Fleet. We went to Loch Fleet to actually see Skelbo Castle ruins. The castle was probably built in the 1130s, but what you see now is the ruined 14th century keep. While beautiful, we had to park a little way down from it and walk up. And as I was walking up to the castle, I heard splash, and I thought, what is making all that noise in the water? And then I saw what it was. Gorgeous harbor seals. I walked right past them. Of course, they're on a sandbar, kind of away from me, but I walked right past them, didn't even notice them till I heard the splashing. So what was going to be a 10-minute, 20-minute stop turned into a couple of hours enjoying iced coffee on my birthday with the harbor seals. Does it get any better than that? And the seals are darn lucky, because what a gorgeous spot. There were also geese and I think a heron. There's a bird that you'll see. I don't know my birds all that well, but it's tall, and you can let me know what you think it is. Good morning. I should have done this a long time ago. We've been up for hours. Well, yeah, a few hours. Mm-hmm. We woke up in our camper van this morning. First morning. It's probably why I look tired. And like I don't have a hairbrush. This behind me is Dunrobin Castle. We've already been to see seals. We had coffee sitting by a bunch of seals. It was amazing. And today is my birthday, so what a fantastic way to celebrate. If I gotta get older, I might as well enjoy it, right? So we're gonna go see Dunrobin Castle, and I'll tell you more about it later. Now that is stunning. Thank you. That was Dunrobin Castle. It was first mentioned around 1401 and thought to be named after Robert the 6th Earl of Sutherland. You can tell I looked this up. I take notes. It was taken by the Jacobites during the Jacobite Uprising and remodeled as seen today between 1835 and 1850. Used as a naval hospital in the First World War and as a boys' boarding school. How cool would it be to go to a school like that? It's like Hogwarts almost. Not quite as, you know, magical, but between 1965 and 1972, since 1973, it's been a private residence. You only get to see a very small part of it, so I'm guessing it's still a private residence because it's huge compared to the part you get to see. But the part you get to see was really pretty. And the garden's gorgeous. So that was stop number 2 for today. On to number 3, which I think we've added a stop because there's a cairn just up the way. It is an Iron Age brook, which means an Iron Age settlement. Now, there are midges out.